Now let us talk about steps involved in setting up YARN as well as MapReduce to using Cloudera Manager. When it comes to Cloudera Manager, there are two different processing engines that can be configured. One is MapReduce, which is a legacy framework, and other one is YARN as well as MapReduce 2, which comes together. We don't need to worry too much about the legacy framework. There are many limitations due to which it faded out and replaced by YARN along with MapReduce 2. If you are curious to understand more about MapReduce, you can go to our YouTube channel called ITversity and search for YARN and MapReduce, and you should be able to get enough resources associated with the legacy as well. That being said, now let us go ahead and understand the steps involved to set up YARN along with MapReduce 2. You just have to expand this and click on Add Service. You can see the options related to MapReduce as well as YARN. So if you want to use legacy frameworks for whatever reason, you just have to choose this and click on continue, and you can actually take care of setting up of MapReduce. In our case, we are interested only in YARN along with MapReduce 2, and hence I'm choosing this, and then I'm hitting continue. Once you hit continue, it will actually ask you to choose the nodes for resource manager, job history server, node manager, etc. As I have explained in topology, resource manager is primarily a master component, and the server on which I want to run resource manager is nothing but Big Data Server 4. And hence I'm choosing Big Data Server 4 here. Job history server is associated with MapReduce. We will understand more about job history server when we talk about the components of YARN and MapReduce 2. For now, let's go ahead and choose Big Data Server 4 itself, even for job history server. And node manager. So node manager is a slave or worker node component, and hence on whatever nodes, data nodes are running, it will try to deploy node manager on them. Typically on most of the production clusters, especially on on-prem, we'll be using the same nodes for both data nodes as well as node managers. Data nodes are primarily for file system. Node manager is primarily for data processing. In case if you don't want to follow that, and if you want to customize, you can go here and you can customize the nodes on which node managers are running. But for our purpose, we'll be configuring node managers on all those nodes on which data nodes are running. As they are already chosen, we just have to click on OK and then hit continue. Now you need to review changes, and if you have to override any of these properties, you can override. The most important property of all these things, which is relevant at this time, is nothing but node manager local directories. So as part of the data processing, node managers has to keep track of certain intermediate data, and this is the location to which that intermediate data should be written. It is scratchpad. Whatever data that goes into this node manager local directories will be deleted automatically at regular intervals, and hence you don't need to worry too much about it. However, we typically choose all those directories on which the data node mount points are mounted. In our case, we have only one, which is nothing but slash data one, and it is automatically chosen. In that, it will create a subdirectory YARN, and then another subdirectory called NM, which stands for node manager. If you want to add more mount points, you can just click on plus, and you can actually give the additional mount points also. If you have multiple mount points, it will automatically choose all the mount points that are available for node manager local directories. You just have to review and make sure that it have made right choices. If not, you have to fix it. Otherwise, you can just click on continue. Don't worry too much about other properties for now. You can just ignore them. Now it is actually creating DFS directories required for YARN, and it will start the services with respect to YARN components. In a while, your YARN cluster will be up and running. Now the directories are created successfully. For whatever reason, if it fails, you have to just expand this and see what is the issue and make sure you take the corrective action. But as it is successful, you just hit continue, and your new service is installed and configured on your cluster. Click on finish. As a new service is added, typically you have to click on this icon and then refresh and deploy client config. It will only take care of deploying the properties files related to all the components on our cluster. Once this deploy is done, we might have to restart the services also. We will see. Once this is taken care of, we will just click on finish. Now the deploy is done. click on finish, and then click on this. Okay, the cluster doesn't have any stale configuration, and hence we can go here. But still there is something showing up here. We need to make sure that they go off. And then if you see yarn is not started automatically for you, you just have to expand this and you just have to say start if it is not started automatically for you. As the configuration is already done, it should start without any issues. However, if it failed, you can actually expand this, and whatever is failed, you can go there and look into the logs. Okay, it will take a while to start the service, so let's wait until it is done and then we will take it further. Now resource manager is also started, and hence we can click on close, and let's refresh this page to make sure that all the components with respect to yarn doesn't have any errors. You can click on this and you can actually get the details. Everything is healthy. Yes, yarn is added successfully to our cluster using Cloudera Manager. Now let us go ahead and configure gateway nodes. Typically, we have to configure only those servers which are designated to run the MapReduce jobs, which is nothing but Big Data Server 1 in our case. But in some cases, we need other nodes also to be configured as gateway nodes. And hence, we will be configuring each and every node starting from Big Data Server, which is a designated gateway node, and all the other nodes as gateway nodes for yarn. To configure gateway nodes, you just have to expand this dropdown and click on add role instances. Earlier, when we try to add yarn, we have seen three options. One is resource manager, second one is job history server, and third one is node manager. Now you see the fourth option called gateway. You can click on this and choose whatever node you want to add gateway node. In this case, I want to add all the nodes as gateway, and hence I have selected all. Then I have clicked on OK and then continue. And then the finish is clicked accidentally, but that is fine. We just have to click on this to make sure that we deploy the configurations on all the nodes as gateways. Now I'm clicking deploy client configuration, and it is actually deploying the client configuration as gateway nodes on all the nodes in the cluster. It will just take a moment. Once it is done, we can actually run MapReduce jobs from the gateway node, which is nothing but Big Data Server 1 going forward. We just have to click on finish here to complete the deploying the client configuration. Now you can actually go to the service and then instances, and you should see that all these servers are added as gateways to the cluster. Yeah, yarn is successfully added to our existing cluster. Now let us review a few things from the command line. First, let us understand the purpose of gateways with respect to yarn. Gateways facilitate us to connect to yarn cluster and issue commands to process data using frameworks like MapReduce, Spark, etc. We will see examples as we proceed further. But for now, we'll actually try to run a couple of Ansible commands to validate few things from the backend. Already, we have created a host group called yarn within our inventory. So setup cluster is a working directory on the gateway node from which I want to run Ansible commands. And there is an inventory file called hosts. And we have added an inventory group called yarn. And we have added 4567 as part of that inventory group. Now using Ansible command against host group yarn, which is part of this file called hosts, I want to run a command called find. Data one is the mount point under which yarn subdirectory will be created on all the worker nodes. And then I just want to search what are all there in the directory. And then we have to specify the private key because we are not using the default key combination. And then become, because data one is owned by yarn and we are connecting as ITVST, and hence we should use sudoer to run this find command on data one, which is owned by user root or yarn, and hit enter. Now you can see that on Big Data Server 4 it failed, which means there is no subdirectory called yarn under data 1, whereas on 5, 6 and 7 there is a subdirectory called yarn on under data 1. And this subdirectory yarn have other subdirectories such as container logs, nm, etc. So these are primarily used for intermediate data. We will be seeing those things at a later point in time. Also, I want to run JPS command for user yarn. I'm just copy pasting from that gist and hit enter. It will show you on what all nodes which component is running with respect to user yarn. You can see that there is a process called node manager on Big Data Server 5, 6, as well as 7. Whereas on 4, it has resource manager. Okay, so this is how you can actually validate the daemon process that is running on the worker nodes on which node manager is configured. Okay, now our yarn cluster is up and running without any issues. We have to submit the jobs and also understand the concepts behind the components associated with the yarn.